Hello guys, welcome to a brand new video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you how you can make this moon base. We're going to be starting by showing you how to build this rover, which has the ability to drive, and by using the RCS thrusters also has the ability to fly. So we're starting off by building this rocket for the rover. We're going to get three of the largest 6 white, one of the smallest normals, and then one of the aerodynamic thing. And you're just going to place it one and a half block from the middle. We're going to get the Hawk engines. Place two of them at the bottom of the rocket, of the side boosters. Going to multiply them. Going to put the other one also 1.5 blocks apart from the middle. Just fix this real quick. And those are side boosters. Then you're going to get one of the Hawk engines, place it a half block above the other four engines of the side boosters. We're going to go with basic things. We're going to get two of the long ones and one of the middle long ones, like this one, which is right here. Then you're going to place a separator on top. You're going to get another Hawk engine. You're going to get one of the one before smallest one and one of the smallest ones. Then you're gonna place another separator on top. You're going to place one of the smaller Valiant engines, don't really know how to pronounce that. You're going to again get one of the smallest ones and one of the one before smallest ones. Then you're going to go to landing legs and you place them right here on both sides, of course. And then you place one of the docking ports on top, and then you are ready to build the rover. So then for the actual rover, you're first gonna get a docking port. You're going to get it on top of the other docking port. Then you're going to go and get one of the smallest basic ones, put it on top of the docking port. You go to aerodynamics, get one of the longer aerodynamic ones. You multiply it and mirror it. Then you're going to place it right here on the other basic one. And you have to really pay attention to this part not sticking out too much like this, or too little like this. So just right like this. Then this one, of course, on the other side. There you get another basic one. You flip it to its side and you get it in the front. Again, sticking out just a little bit. Then you go to basics, you get two of them. You flip down like this. Now I'm just gonna first gather the parts that you need, so also one of the control things. You also need two wheels facing this side and RCS thrusters, but you don't really need to get them yet because you don't need to flip them. Then you're going to place these two parts right here. You're going to place them into this one. Just like so. You're getting a docking port, the control thing inside of the front fuel tank, like that. Then you get one of the wheels on the front and another one in the back. Just like so. And then you get three RCS thrusters, which you place on the bottom side of the rover, in kind of the gap that is now formed. Just like so, you just select all of it and you move it around to get them all inside each other. And that's it for the rover. And of course I forgot the most important thing, which are the separators, which you of course need to put between the side boosters and the middle of the rocket. I will now be showing you how to get it to the moon. But until I am in orbit, I will be speeding up the footage because it will take a while. So, we now have an orbit. It isn't perfectly circularized, but it isn't really needed if you want to go to the moon. So what you want to do, you just want to click on the moon, navigate to, and it will show you how much you need to accelerate. And for me, it's now about 600 meters a second, I think. Yeah, 614. And so you're just going to accelerate and get pointing towards the arrow, which you can see on the right side of my screen. And you see your orbit expanding, which is a good thing. I'm now out of fuel, so I'm going to stage. Like that. And you have to lower the throttle when you're getting close to zero. Because otherwise you might overshoot it. So as you can see, I'm now lowering the throttle to only 30%. I'm getting even closer, so I'm going to lower it to a bit less even. Then when it disappears, you know you are going to be intersecting the moon. Then you're going to the moon and you will see the line of how you will be intersecting it. And then what you want to do, you just want to get it close to the moon. And you can either leave it here, and then when you are there, you can decelerate and form an orbit around the moon, and from there go on to land on the moon. But I'm just going to go like this, which will take a bit more fuel, but we have that on this rocket, so it's fine. And then I'm just going to quick save. Like that. And you're just gonna time warp a bit. Oh, and I see I forgot to clear my debris. Just like that. And then you have to slow the time warp when you're getting close to the moon, because you will be accelerating. Because you get close to the moon, you get in the gravity field of it. So as you can see, I'm now at 500 kilometers. I'm already going to get it pointing downwards. Oh, and downwards is towards the arrow thing again, as you can see. I'm going to go to about 50 kilometers in height, I think. Now it's 70, and as you can see, I'm still moving at 400 meters a second, which of course is way too fast. So I'm going to decelerate a bit already, and then when I get to about 300, I'm just going to stop accelerating and time warp a bit. Just like that. Yeah, now at 30 kilometers in height. So So now I'm definitely going to decelerate a bit more. I'm out of fuel, so I'm going to separate this stage. And I'm also going to extend the landing legs already, because that is a typical thing to forget. Don't want that to happen now. I'm going to clear my debris, even though it would, the stage I just separated would crash into the moon whatsoever. I'm now only moving at 150 meters a second, so I'm just going to stop again. So I'm at right about here. I'm going to burn a bit again to decelerate more, because we don't want to crash into the moon, we want to land there. As you can see, we now passed the 5 kilometers in height, because it flips us to this way better view. And you gotta make sure you don't go up again, so your velocity doesn't get to zero and then up again. So I'm going to lower the throttle, which will still have me accelerating, but just not much. Or, I mean, decelerating, sorry. And here you can also see how much horizontal velocity you have, which you want to be, want to get to be around zero. You can see me doing that now. And we are now at 2 kilometers in height. You can see I just cancelled most of my horizontal velocity. We still have 50% fuel left in this stage, so that's great, that's more than enough. As you can still, as you can see, we are still moving at almost 35 meters per second, so we are going to have to get on the throttle again, because we're now at 500 meters and we, when we are at zero, we want our velocity to be right around 1 meter a second. So as you can see me putting up the throttle again now, to decelerate to only 30 meters a second, 13, excuse me. And now I'm just going to be using this camera, because it's way easier when you land. And of course pay attention to your horizontal velocity, but also to your vertical velocity. You can see I'm now only moving 3 meters a second downwards, and still 7 to the side, which is a bit too much for my liking, so I'm going to get that to be a little bit less. Now I'm going to decelerate before I touch down on the moon. And as you can see, I'm only moving 0.8 meters a second, 0.5, 0.4, and touchdown. So, and what I didn't do this mission, what you can do is quick save once you get closer to the landing. That's of course also very important if you're a bit more of a beginner, because it's just, yeah, you have to learn how you can do this stuff. So when you screw up, you can go from your quick save, which is of course very handy. And now I am going to quick save, because we still need to undock this rover, which is also kind of a problem with this this particular build. Yeah, I'm going to show you how to do it, and I think you can do it yourself too. So for the undocking part of this rover, what you need to do, you need to put up this throttle again, so that it will go up a bit. Then you need to get it to go sideways, and then undock so that the rover will safely land. So I'll show that right now. I'm starting with 1% and just slowly moving it up. Then I'm going to go sideways, moving the throttle down a bit again, and then undocking. And it is kind of a mess now, but I'm just going to clear the breeze. And then you can switch on the rover wheels and you can move it. And what you want to do, because of course we are going to land buildings next to it, so you want to find kind of a flat spot. Actually, I landed in kind of a flat spot now, but I'm going to go a bit more to the right from this view, because it's a bit more flat there. And those buildings are way easier to land when it's on flat ground. Oh, and I'm going to be trying to land the buildings on the left of the rover, because I just prefer that. You can of course also land them on the right side of the rover. So there we have it. I'm just going to stop right here. And I'm going to switch off the rover wheel so that it doesn't move when I'm not controlling it. And now we're ready to get to building the rockets that you need for the building itself, and then launching them next to our rover. So now for the bottom part of the buildings, because we're going to launch them in two parts. This is more of a bigger and complicated rocket, but I think you all can make it. So you get two of the longest six wides. You place them in each other like this. Then you do that again one more time. So just like this. Then you go to the one before longest one, and you place that one like this too. Then you go to basics, you get one of the smallest ones, and you place them both like this, so that it gets the slope thing. Then you get one of the smallest six wides. Then you go to basic again. You get one of the smallest ones here, and then a pointy bit. Then you're going to duplicate this, and you're going to put them two blocks apart from the middle. And they will also touch the edge here. I'm just going to move them up a bit, because we need to fit the engines under there. So, just like this, you're going to put three Hawk engines. Just like so. And then you're going to get one of the Hawk engines again, actually two of them, and you're going to be placing them half a block below the edge of this one, the bottom of this one. So two of them, and you go to six wides. I'm going to place two of the longest six wides, and for some reason I can't right now. Let's try to fix it using this. There we go. Then one of the separators. Then we place two engines again. Again inside each other. And then you go to six wide again. You get one of the longest ones, and one of the one before smallest ones. And for some reason it doesn't work again, but we fix it like this. And you go to separator, well, to other, and then you put one of the separators, the docking ports, right in the middle. And then you can build the bottom side of one of the buildings. So now for the actual bottom of the building, so the actual building. You're first gonna place separators, because of course I forgot it again. There are always those small things you forget. Then this one, docking port on top. then you place two of the longest six whites, and then you place two of the longest normal ones, and you clip them inside each other, just barely. Then you do the same on the bottom, but you need to place one landing leg right there to, of course, land safely. So you're doing this, so then you see the landing leg is still there, which is important. Then you're going to do the same on the other side. So, and then you are going to real quick do a test. So of course you need a little control thing on top, just to see if the landing legs work. So you try to click really on the side of this entire building. So yeah, sometimes it will show how much fuel you have. So it might take a couple tries, just click a couple times. And there you see that the landing legs are working. So then you can go on with your build. So yeah, so you start with one of the docking ports again. You go to basics, excuse me, you can first go to water. You place one of the controls right in the middle. Then you go to basics, you get one of the smallest ones. And you place it inside of the one control thing. Then you go to six white. And you, it didn't go as planned. Just like that. And you go to the edge of the building thing. And then what you need to do, you need to place two Hawk engines right there. So that is really important. Because with this building you will do kind of like a skycrane maneuver from the Perseverance rover and the Curiosity rover. So if you don't have those, you will just crash into the moon. And that's it for the build. So now for the launch. And I will speed everything up until it gets interesting. Now this is when things get interesting, because as you see, I've almost run out of the fuel inside of the side boosters, so they are now stopping. You of course need to separate them, and then you will run out of fuel on the other stage also real quick. Then you get away with that stage. And then you're first going to get your apoapsis to about 45 to 50 kilometers in height. As you see, it's only 33 now. So, of course, we just need to wait a bit. And what you want to do is you want to select the fuel tanks of the building. You want to transport fuel into the other stage. Because otherwise it would run out, and you have a lot of fuel in this stage that you don't need in the building itself. So this is a high enough apoapsis, So you're just gonna time warp towards it, and you're flipping it horizontally, your rocket. Then what you wanna do, you wanna transport fuel to here, and you wanna also select these two engines, so that you have way more acceleration. And then you transport fuel from the building to the other thing again. And you're just going to wait till you have a nice circular orbit. Well, not exactly circular, but at least just an orbit. As you can see, I've almost run out of fuel in this one, so I'm going to transport it from this to this one. So, as you can see, I now have an orbit, and we are ready to go to the moon. Okay, so as you can see, I'm now going to the moon, but there is one very important thing, which is that, first of all, I need to see which of these is my right rover. Okay, so this one isn't. So this one is the right rover, so we want to go to this one. We want to select our craft that is going to the moon. And sometimes you can just, most of the times actually, you can just go straight towards your target, which is this one. But sometimes you can't because of how you are positioned. So I'm just going to show you, and then you have to first make an orbit. So I'm going to show you how to do that, just in case you are unlucky and you get that one, and you don't know how to do it. To deal with it, so this craft is really heavy, so sometimes when you're turning you will overshoot the turn. So I'm going to go like this, and then you have a low point, but still above the surface at the moon, and then you want to decelerate when you are right there. And then you will get an orbit, but I will now show it. But I will speed it up a bit, because it is already a very long video, and otherwise it would be even longer. Oh, and don't forget to quick save. So as you can see, we now have an orbit around the moon, and we want to land right here. So what you want to do, you want to time warp until you are right about above it, a bit ahead of it actually. And you want to turn your craft around to be able to decelerate. And you need the little arc that you will form then to end right about where your craft is, where you want to land. So this line is now going towards it. They're going to put a little bit less throttle, and even less when you're getting closer. And you just, watch when it is close enough. So that's right about around here. We're only going 40 meters per second, so we don't really need this stage anymore to brake for us to decelerate. So we're going to transport all of its fuel into our building. And once that's done, we're going to get it away. And then we are going to extend the landing legs. Just like so. And then we're going to transfer all of the fuel to there. And for now, we're not going to stop that until we are really close to the surface. Because, of course, we need a lot of fuel. And the fuel tanks right on this stage are, of course, really, really small. So you don't have the ability to store a lot of fuel there. So I'm now going to go to about 10 kilometers. And I'm going to switch on my engines, because we are going 300 meters per second, which is way too much. And you do need to pay attention that this line will still end up right around where you want to land. So as you can see, I am managing that right now, at least trying to. And make sure you don't get too low velocity and you go up again, because that's just a waste of fuel. As you can see, I'm now going only 35 meters per second, which is very nice, but still, of course, way too fast. But we are still 1700 meters above the surface, so that's fine. So we're now getting really close to the surface. So I'm going to decelerate even more. We're basically going to land as close as possible to our rover, which of course is already on the surface. Oh god, a bit too much to that side. As you can see, we're now moving really slowly. And we're now going to land on top of the rover, so we need to make a bit of corrections. Because of course we don't want to land on our rover and destroy it. Oh, and again, I forgot to quick save, but when you are doing it, please remember to quick save, because you don't want to do the mission again. Almost there. Touchdown. So that's it for the landing, but we still need to get away our sky crane. So I'm gonna do that next. So for the sky crane maneuver, what we want to do, we want to transfer all our fuel into the stage with the engines. We want to get them burning. But not too much so that it will lift up again. Then we undock it and we throttle up even more. And then we get in an orbit around the moon. Which for some reason I can't do right now. It's kind of easy to get an orbit around the moon when you're taking off from the moon, because of course the gravity on the moon is very low. As you can see, I almost have one right here. And now I can't time warp until I get at 5 kilometers. So it's just a bit of waiting, which is kind of annoying, but you just need to. I can actually accelerate a bit more upwards because I have enough fuel, so that it will go a bit quicker, just like so. Actually, I can just accelerate fully until I'm at. Yeah, that's 1,000 kilometers in height is enough. Now I can time warp until I'm at that apogee. And once you're there, you want to accelerate so that it gets a straight line from your apogee, well, about a straight line, to the ground of the moon, surface of the moon. Then you're going to be time warping. And what you want to do, because of course there is a control thing in here, and it's very well protected because of the fuel tank. So you need to slam into the moon as hard as you can to destroy the thing, otherwise it will be left there. So of course we don't want that. So just like so. And you can just burn until you don't have fuel left, because you won't slow down because there isn't an atmosphere at the moon. As you can see, we're moving really, really fast towards the moon at 2000 meters per second. Actually 2500 now. So we're going to time warp, and as you can see, that's off. So now that that's gone, we can go to here and we can enjoy the first part of our moon base. Of course we need to also get the upper part, which will be on top of this building, otherwise it isn't a complete building. But I will show that in another video, because this video is already very long, and the other stuff is also gonna take very long. So I'm gonna wrap up the video here. I really hope you enjoyed and learned something, and of course I'm going to do the other video where I get the top part of this building. So if you don't want to miss that, then please subscribe and hit the bell, and then I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you and bye bye. So guys, there was one thing I forgot to tell, which is that when you are building this part, you need one of the control things in there, because otherwise when you clear the breeze when you're launching your next rocket, the whole thing will get destroyed. So I'm very sorry I didn't tell this earlier on in the video, but I hope it didn't happen to any of you guys already. So if that did happen, then I'm very sorry. I hope you it wasn't too bad and you could recover from one of your quick saves. But yeah, my excuses for that.